now we can start analyzing. We'll get much better results by using the Zebra BI visuals. On top of my revenue, we'll build the revenue for previous year. First of all, separate actual from the plan. So that's why I will build my first measure. Click new measure. All right. And we'll call it revenue actual. All right. So this is the actual part of my data. So first of all, we'll just sum all the revenue, the values of the revenue column. All right. Like that. So that would be just, you know, normal measure, just pure measure without any kind of filtering. But now I need to filter it. So that's why I will use the formula called the calculate. Calculate will now take the sum of my revenue field and then filter this. So I'll use another formula called filter, which will actually filter my sales table. So first of all, I type sales. This is my sales table, and I'll extract, and now I'll use the filter expression. So I'll use this scenario column, and I'll type my condition here. The scenario column should match actual. So all the rows that are labeled actual, this is my actual revenue here. A couple of more braces here, and now I have my revenue, my actual revenue. So now I will not use the column here, but I will use this measure in my chart. So I'll actually throw out the old one and I'll throw in the actual. So this is now truly my actual sales in December 2017. Now that we have this, we can also create another measure for the previous year. All right, so with this, so now we'll say, all right, revenue previous year equals. So now I'll just take the actual, the revenue from actual, and just shift the year for, you know, minus one. So just 1 year back. And you do this by using the calculate formula. And we'll take my actual revenue. Now we need the formula for the previous year. There are like three or four ways how you do this with DAX. I typically use the date add function, which is kind of the most versatile and just safest to work with. And now you say, all right, my dates from the calendar. So your date field from the calendar. That's it. And we'll just shift it for 1 year back. That's why I type minus one here. And I just say, all right, minus 1 year. That's it. So this formula takes my revenue and just shifts it for 1 year back. Close it. And I've got the revenue from previous year. All right. So this is now the basic condition, the minimal model in Power BI to start building your comparison. Add this revenue for previous year into my visual, and now the magic starts to happen. Only now we can start building reports in Power BI.